Hi everyone, it's Eddie here. Welcome back to my channel. And today I am gonna show you the three journals that I've started working on. I'm mainly gonna talk about what I'm kind of doing, and then I'm gonna show you how I put down the covers. But first, how are you? I hope you're well. Thank you for stopping by. So I've had been given, and I also purchased at a thrift shop, several of these golden books, little golden books, right? And so I decided I'm gonna use three of them to make journals. And so I cut off that golden part spine. I know some people keep it. These were kind of roughed up, and I just decided I'm going to just slice it off, keep it off. And then I made I think this is an inch and a half spine. So I can do up to four signatures. I'm still deciding on how many signatures. I think I'm gonna do three, just so it's not, you know, so bulky, but there's plenty of stuff. And you've noticed I've already put covers down. Oh, and by the way, this is black gaffer tape. It's for bookbinding and such. It's like a fabric-y sort of tape, right? But it adheres well. It's got a nice, soft, smooth finish. And it works really, really well. So once I taped it all together, so basically what I did, I took the two covers, front and back, and I laid down my little spine here and kind of laid it out as best I could, as evenly as I could, allowing for a gap between the cover and the spine so that you can easily fold the book open and close, right? You can easily open and close the book. That's what I meant to say. So basically I just went over this with the black gaffer tape, and then I took my bone folder, and you notice here, I went in here and just gently burnished this down so that I got nice contact with the tape, and that I could define the folds so that it would close up nicely for me. So there you go. And then for the covers, now I did take the innards out, and I'm gonna keep them, but I don't know what I'll use them for. Not yet, but I will. So this is another cover. Okay. So those are the covers. And I went ahead and actually, I did put tape on this one. And now you see this is coming out because I didn't have enough tape. It wasn't wide enough. So I'm gonna do this over, but what I'm gonna do is, instead of taking all of this apart, I'm just simply gonna go over it with tape on this side. And this is a great tape that you can cut in half easily. You can rip it usually. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna take a piece like this, and then I'm fine a half, split it down the middle, and then I'm gonna go from the front to the inside. Just make sure everything is tucked in where it's supposed to be. And this is why you take your time. And I haven't made journals in a while, so I'm a little bit rusty, but not that rusty. You're always gonna come across something that doesn't go exactly your way. So just be prepared for that, and you know, it'll be a lot less stressful. So you see, I'm taking the bone folder and going down that crease nice and gently. I'm not like using the tip, I'm just using the side. Give me a nice burnish. Let's do this other side while we're here. Okay, let me put this side on here, on the other side, the white, because you can see the bits of the white from the back. So I'm just gonna think once I bind them, I may cover the spine with these strips of fabric. And these are fabric, this is muslin that I stamped with acrylic paint and just different foam stamps of mine. Yada yada. And so I thought that maybe I could attach these to the spine and put it over the, what do you call those things? The actual binding, the threads. So, but I haven't decided yet, so I'm gonna hold off on that until almost the very end, right before we get to stitching, because that's gonna depend on what we do. All right, so let's get this side down. All right, we're secure, no problem. Going straight, yeah. A little wonky, but it's gonna be hidden by the paper we're gonna put over. And so for the covers, I've decided, let's see, stands great, but here's another trick. You take one side, go down like this, and then you push it back this way to get the other edge. Kind of fold it like that. Just press it a little bit, and it should do better. And there we go. So here, I'm not worried about that right now. Okay. So what I did is I picked out some gel prints to put on the front and back covers. The inside, I'm gonna use some scrapbook paper that's, you know, already pre-printed paper. I haven't decided which ones yet. And so that's gonna be the covers. And then these, in my previous video, you saw me working on these. All right, so there's some papers. These are gel prints that I'm gonna use as pages in my journal. So, you know, you'll have your gel print page, you'll have some painty paper. Maybe we'll have some coffee dyed paper in here. And we'll just, so this will be, you know, in the mix. Okay. Now, this is not the typical size, obviously, of an 8.5 by 11, you know, book. Or a book that will fit an 8.5 by 11 sheet like this, folded in half. So we're gonna have to make adjustments. I'm not worried about that. And my thinking is some of these pages will get folded up because it's not a lot to take off. So instead of cutting it, I may just fold it up. I don't know yet. I haven't decided. But yeah, so that's my idea for the signatures. And then also I have other papers to put in there also with. I've got some envelopes. Let me show you this envelope I made. So, I have some utility bill envelopes that I gel printed over, just kind of grungy style. And inside each end, that kind of slice the end open, got a little journal card. And this, the journal cards, I made with a gel print. So, this is some great ways to use your gel prints. I took a gel print that I did on tissue, and I glued it down to some cardstock and then cut it down according to the size of the opening. So for this one, for example, it is 3.5, almost 3.5 tall by roughly 4 inches wide. And depending on your envelope, obviously you want to check your measurements. But I usually trim off the excess of the paper, right? But I was like, you know, it's a journal card. So I could, you know, write something on here. I could put a label down or just leave it blank for the recipient to write in it. But I thought that's a great idea, a great way to use up those gel prints. So I'll make more of those later, another video. And so I'm gonna kind of clear this up. Since I've explained what I'm gonna do, let's move this out of my way. And I'm gonna head, I cut down some papers already for the covers. So these are for the two other covers. Although, no, there is the one cover that I still have to put the black tape on. So I have one, I have two, and then where's my third one? Did I put you here? Here you are. Is it three or four? It's three. So, yeah, they're just three. Okay, I'm just making sure because my brain's a little fragile today. Okay, yeah, so I was originally going to do this size of a spine. This is 1 inch. Yeah. But I decided to go with bigger because I always, you know, try to stay small and not too bulky, and it just doesn't go that way. So I went with a bigger spine to allow me to stuff it like I want to. All right, so this one goes. So these are all my innards. And these will be fun to use on something else. We can even use it in these if we wanted to. Use images from it. But for now, I'm going to set them to the side with other papers. Pages. Okay. And for the next cover, let's put down the tape and we'll get that done. Here's our spine. So let me just line this up with my grid here. Little space here. This might be a little long, but I'm gonna, you know, let me pull it down so I can see it better. Line it up with the bottom line here. Oops. That's good. Let me line up this side here. And I can see right away, the spine is a little long. So I will have to trim it. But I'll do that. I'm gonna do that in a second. I wanna make sure these are lined up properly before I go any further. That's good. So I might have to use some extra tape on that one, but I'm not worried about it. So I had a pencil. This'll do. I'm just gonna, should be about enough. Well, I should measure it with this. Do it the old-fashioned way. Trim that little bit off. Perfect. All right, let's back these up again. Let's line these up. Some tape, and I'm feeling that one's not right. Now the edges are a little wonky, so I gotta take that into account because I didn't slice it like perfect, but I'm not gonna worry about that. That's just not a problem. So you see this tape's not gonna cover it all, so I'm gonna go ahead and just do two strips of tape. And just I'm gonna cut this one with the scissors so I don't tear it off the book. Okay. Come on, back in place. Let's see if I can get the right measurement. Yeah, about there. Bam. Be careful because it does like to stick onto itself, and it does it quickly. Oh, come on. Not now. All right. So lay you down. We'll make sure we overlap with that center, with that other piece. And while it's down, I'm going to take my bone folder again and go down that seam. Why are you giving me trouble? This is just, I'm gonna try some of this off because we're gonna have another piece going the other way, so I'm not worried about that. That stuff is sticky. Let's go the other way. This never happens when the camera's not on, trust me, because the other ones I did were done in 2 seconds. But for some reason, you turn that camera on and, oh, see, you know, just a mess. Promise I'll get this right. All right, I'm just gonna just leave it be. Pull that up. And then I'm gonna go this way with me tape. So yeah, it's not gonna cover, so I'm gonna do two pieces again over here. Fold these over and get everything situated properly. Okay, again, I'm going to come in on the inside of the book and use my bone folder to score those edges or the little grooves here. Much better. Okay. There we go. All right, so for the next part, we're going to go ahead and glue down the covers. Front and back. And I gotta make sure I keep this right, because there was one book I almost put the back cover on the front. It was upside down. It was this way and that. But luckily, I stopped myself. So I chose this one for the front. So that'll go there. And then this for the back. I'm not going to lose too much of the print. I cut off the white edges because I don't have a plate big enough to cover the entire paper. So I have 8x10 prints on 8.5x11 paper. Just trim the white off. Start over here. So I'm gonna come over up to the edge here, not exactly to the edge, but up to the edge. And then I'm going to press press my hand, my finger, along the edges while trying to hold the paper steady and sort of kind of score it of where it's gonna go. Could use my bone folder, but I'm just afraid I might rip the paper, so I tend to be a little heavy-handed. Let's see here. I think I could do it. Okay. And then if we flip it over, you can see what part's going to go on the book. Now for the corners, you're going to want to take some off of here, right? And then kind of go in this way and take that off of that side. So that when you fold it up, fold it over, you get a nice smooth corner. So go like that. But I gotta get some glue. Today I'm using Aileen's original tacky glue, and it worked great on the other covers, so I'm not gonna change from that. Media brush and see, I want to get it right to like there. The groove is here, so I'm getting it right to there, and that way it's not in the actual groove, so the paper won't come up from, you know, opening and closing the book. Get a nice smooth edge. Get her down. And I have a smoother outer. Go from the outside, from the inside out, or from the center outwards. Better way to say it, yeah? Look at that. Beautiful. Let's flip her over. You see on this side, ready to go. Get some glue up here. I do one at a time just to make sure that I'm not messing anything up. Get this glue down nice and evenly, right up to the edge there. And pull it towards you. You see there's a little extra there, this corner. So I'm just gonna come in with my scissor and get that little snip. This one too. And technically you could do this little corner trimming after you get the initial cover down. But it ain't no big deal to me. Get a little glue here. Yes, I thought, I've been looking at these darn books forever on a shelf. I said, let me do something with them. And let's make some journals. Because I don't have what I usually use, which is like an Amazon mailer or a larger envelope. What else to use, or chipboard. I have black chipboard, but it's just, I thought it was too thick for what I want to do here, so I'll save that for something else. And I'm going to use these little golden books instead. And there you have it. We have our front cover all done. Now for the back cover, we've got bricks. And yeah, that's good. So let me line this up and score it again like I did the other one. I don't want to go like right. Yeah, that's the ticket. Give it a little score. Where's my bone folder? Here we go. I'll do that one. That one. All right. A little glue. Got this stuff really cheap. I can't remember where. I want to say it was maybe Amazon. It could have been Joanne. I think it was Amazon. Anyway, it was quite inexpensive. I think I caught it on a sale. So I said, let me get some of that because I do have some white glue, but it's not as strong. It's the Elmer's. It's not as strong. And then also, I was hoping to do some covers with fabric soon. So maybe, so that'll be helpful. Oops, someone's knocking stuff down in the garage. Yeah, my little space here that I call my mansion is literally next to the garage. Luckily, they don't keep cars in there, so there's no, you know, issue with fumes or anything like that. Although, you know, some days, here we go, put this down. And baby wipe will also take off that excess glue that may seep out, but it shouldn't. I had a little bit on the first cover I did, but it wiped off pretty good. I was saying before about clipping the corners and come in now and clip here and then here. And that should be good. Where's the garbage? Glue. And this is just a great way to spend the afternoon, especially now it's getting so cold out. It's been in the 30s at night lately here, which is fine with me, but you know, I don't mind staying at home and being cozy and doing cozy things. Although I've been binge watching all kinds of really good detective series from BritBox. And they are awesome. But of course, you can't see all the seasons because some of them, you know, are on another platform that you have to pay for, or they haven't been released yet, which is, you know, understandable. But there's a couple where I've watched. See, what they do is like, it's called like a series or a season. But what it is like 4 or 5, maybe 6 hour, hour and a half long episodes. And it's, you know, it's the same story. And it's this long, you know, it's this investigation and all the little, you know, jump off points from the investigation and, you know, getting to know all the different characters and how they work. And, you know, so by like usually the second or third episode, I've got like my suspects narrowed down to about 3 or 4. There's a couple I've watched that I've guessed it like at the beginning, and then I started doubting myself because they'll do that, you know, they throw in some red herrings and watch you squirm. But oh, they're so fun. Really good. Okay. We are rocking and rolling. So yeah, this is what I'm gonna do today, is just do the covers, and then hopefully the next video it will be getting them into the book, the signatures into the book, but there's still papers I need to pick out and put in, and then figure out what order. So I think maybe that'll be the next video, but between now and then I'll pull the papers or other papers to put in. So I gotta, look through mustaches and stuff like that. All right, so this is the first one we did. This is our second one. Let me lay these over here. Out of the way. And for my next book, I have these two awesome prints. So this will be my front cover, and this is the back cover. Really nice greens and blues, all that beautiful stuff. So front cover is here. So I want to line this up again. Not going completely to the edge of where the groove begins, but just a little bit behind it so that you don't run into the problem of this paper peeling up when you're, opening and closing the book, because that'll happen. I'm looking at my shirt. I thought I spilled something, but no, this is a spill from, it's actually not a spill. It's a acrylic marker stain. So I'm always going, nope, that's just permanent. But if you're an artist, you know how that goes. Everything is covered in paint or some sort of medium like glue or something. And God forbid you work with glitter, because that's everywhere too. I tend to stay away from the glitter. I grew up with a mom who loved glitter on everything, so we always had glitter everywhere. When it was my turn to vacuum, the couches and clean them, always found glitter and coins that I got to keep. Don't move on me now. So what were we talking about? Oh, the detective series. They're great. I wish I could get you. Let me see if I can pull up the names on my computer here. It's in front of me. Doo-doo-doo, the mouse isn't working. Here we go. Nope, it's not up, but I can easily pull it up. So some of them I've watched this is the newest one is Passenger, and that is a really cool one. It's brand new, so there's only one season out, but it's like 6 long episodes, and it's really good. Most of these take place in small towns or villages. This is definitely one of them. Then there's another one called After the Flood. I just started watching that. And that is after the historic floods in some parts of England. Weird things happened and people died. And so there is a detective who is, well, she's not a detective yet, but she is looking into it as much as she can. And then there is Unforgotten. Good one. That's a really, really good one. Endeavor. Endeavor is the prequel of Inspector Morse. The Inspector Morse series. That's pretty famous. And the Inspector... So this one stars you have your head detective, and then Morse comes in as a new assistant detective. I forget what the names are. DSI or DS something or other. He's a sergeant detective. And so this is when he was younger and fresh out of school and it takes place in Oxford, and he attended Oxford, but he didn't go on that academic route. He decided he wanted to be a police officer, and he is clever as heck, but of course, you know, when you're brand new, no one wants to hear from you because you're new. They want you to just listen and learn, but he's a pushy guy. And he was, of course, you know, it's his show. He was always right, or usually always right. But it's some great stories, have great characters. Just, it really, you know, some of them are touching. Some of them are hilarious. Some of them are scary. But they're all really good. And that takes place late 60s, early 70s. That's the time frame of that series. And what's another one maybe I can tell you about? Lewis is a good series too. That was L-E-W-I-S. Very good series. Another one, Midsummer Murders. I love that one. And I think I've watched every season except the two newest seasons, which again are available only as a on another paid subscription, which I'm like, yeah, I'll just wait for it to come out on BritBox or whatever. Did I watch The Pale Horse? I don't know if I watched that one. Yeah, so those are the ones that I've watched completely, almost completely. I just started the Flood one after the Flood. I just started that probably 2 days ago. So, but yeah, they've got some wonderful shows on there. I like period detectives too, like, you know, the Sherlock Holmes series. And the best Sherlock Holmes series for me is, let's see if I can find it here. Type in Sherlock. And it's not the modern one. It is The Adventures of Sherlock, starring Jeremy Brett. He plays Sherlock, a very famous actor over there. And he's wonderful. He's very, what's the word? What's the word? Eccentric. It's eccentric, but not really. I can't think of the word. He's kind of campy in a way. Especially in his mannerisms and some of his, you know, the way he speaks, but it's really good. And that one has, I think, that's four seasons on BritBox, and it's from the 80s. But it takes place in, you know, the original Conan Doyle's, time period, which is, I want to say it's late Victorian, but yeah, so it's really good. And okay, let's get this back on. So this will be the back, and which way do we want it? Yeah, we're gonna go this way. See, that tape had its own idea of what it wanted to do. Let me see if I can smooth it out a little bit. And then define that line again. Okay. That's better. Yeah, so if you want to see how I created a lot of the prints that are going to use, that are going to be used in these journals, watch my previous video. It's called Craft Paints and Quick Pulls. Basically, I'm using craft paints, mostly craft paints, to decorate or paint up the opposite side of prints I already had, so that it's a double-sided page and just a single side. So, like, let's see. That's another good one. So, there's these two sides here. This is originally Brayer-Offs, and I added some stenciling and some other stuff. Here's another good one. This is actually the inside, and this is the outside. That's the outside, and then this is our inside. So, yeah, fun. Good video, quick video. All right, let's glue you down, buddy. And I'm looking at this, I think this, yeah, this is upside down, but it doesn't matter because it's getting covered up on both sides, so that's not a big deal. Let me see, am I right? No, it's actually right. I just have it upside down. Okay, thought I was going nutsy for a while, but yeah, no big deal because we're gonna cover up the insides. And like I said, I think I'm gonna use some scrapbook paper I have. That'll be cool on the inside, because it's gonna be a lot of gel prints through the book. So I may use that. I've got a lot of scrapbook paper I gotta use. And yeah. And some of it I may alter, so hopefully I'll get that done on video so you can see. It's fun altering gel scrapbook papers with your gel plate. There's my fold here, or my groove here. There's so much paint on these prints because there's each one has a couple of layers on it. Each side has a couple of layers on it that they're nice and strong because, you know, if the acrylic paint is basically a plastic. So they're nice and sturdy. Yeah, the other side I didn't like too much, so I turned it, I decided to use it as a cover instead of a page in the book. And we'll get the glue here. And then I gotta think about closures too, what I wanna use to use as a closure. I don't have to have one, but I think it might be cool. Just gotta think about one that will work for me. I'm trying to use up stuff I already have. I'm not trying to buy anything extra, which is kind of the point of junk journals, is, you know, use what you've got. That's what I've been trying to do. So a lot of these gel prints were just sitting there and they were kind of like half ugly. And so yeah, I just got them back on the gel plate with different paint and maybe a different stencil. And voila, you have a new print. That's why I don't throw away my gel prints, even if they're not aesthetically pleasing to my eye. You can find a way to work with them. That's for sure. And I can show you some of the ephemera I've been working on to to use in these journals. Some of them is made from, some of it's made from gel prints, some from scrapbook paper, and some kind of like ideas I was working on, and then hopefully make some, do some mass makes on video for you to see. And what I like to do is let these dry flat, because you'll notice the chipboard's gonna wanna start to curve because of the moisture from the glue. So just lay them out flat and they'll be fine. So by tomorrow, these will be nice and flat and ready to go. This is just some play I had with some book pages. Let's see, three pocket, this is a little coin envelope. This is just a little envelope with music paper. Another coin envelope with the poem on the front. And this is a pocket. And this is another pocket. So this one will be, you know, pocket in the back. And then this little pocket there. Oops, just stuff I was cutting. Here's another pocket here, and this I made with book page. Some of that. And what do I got here? My friend Becky made this one. This is a large piece of music paper she made into a folder. Not a folder, pocket. So 1, 2, 3, 4. And if you tuck anything in the back, that's 5 pockets. So yeah, and this is one of her notes from her. She sends me gel print with a note in the back when she sends me something. It's really cute. I save them all. I don't use them in anything. Some more pockets. Book page, pocket. And these are just basic, so they'll you know, I can decorate more of them. And this was a couple of delicate book pages that I glued together and just made into a pocket. So now it's nice and sturdy. There's another little, that one didn't work so well. Some envelopes. So this one, as you can see, I scored it in such a way to make it gusseted, and I guess that's the word. Got a little string here, and then a couple of die-cut leaves I glued on there. Again, this is a gel print. Both sides are gel printed, and so you've got, you know, room for stuff that will stay in there. But here, we'll put this in there, just so you could see how it looks. You put a little ephemera in there, and then you tie it up. Voila. And then I have, oh, and these are little, like, these maybe little charms I did from book page and some scrap. What do you call that? Not construction paper, cardstock. with book page glued on it, and it was, I had already gel printed on it. I was doing something else. So I just, let me use it for this, and did some stamping on it just for fun. So put a little grommet in there. So we'll see. And then this is a little belly band to hold the envelope closed, made of gel prints. Also the envelope made of gel prints. This is a little, one of my stamps I used that in one of my previous videos, I stamped out a bunch of images onto cardstock and then cut them out and then colored them or glued them in. And this is just a nice basic envelope. You see I've got little stuffs in here already. And so this is what I stamped and cut out. So the recipient can color their own. And this I could cover up with something else or leave it like that. Not sure yet. But yeah, so a little belly band on that one. And then this one is cool. This one is a print I received on cardstock in a swap. And then I added some more layers on top, added a couple of discs of cardstock with what are those things called? You know what I mean, the pins. And then this is how it opens. So really cool. It's already been inked. And the gold you see here is just gold pen I shakily applied to the envelope. It's not even at all, but it's okay. It goes with the whole look. And then at the end, I put a little paper bead here that I made to decorate it. I guess I could do more. This string is kind of long, but whatever. There we go. That's another one. Here's another fun one. This grubby print. And then I added just different piece of gel print and just some labels in the back and more gel print. And then this is a little label thingy I'm using as the closure. So that's fun. Here's another large one. Envelope, I mean. And I've got another one of my stamped images there. I've got this leaf and a flower. Little airmail, little flower here. I think Darcy made these for me. And this gel print has stuff on the both sides, so I'm not worried about anything there. So that's cool. Then I was just fussy cutting some images on that one. And these you saw me make on the YouTube. I think I made these on the video. So there's a little pocket there. Journal card, those. Yeah, you watched me make these. If you haven't, go back a couple of videos, it's there. And so we have those, tag. Okay, where's some other ones I made? Here's another bookmark, not a bookmark, a belly band. Here is some scrapbook paper that I made pockets with. So this is one pocket there, and then when you glue it down, you got your second pocket, and added some stamping. And this one's cute. This is one strip of paper, and you've got one pocket there and then the one in the back. And then you can even tuck something right up in here if you wanted to, like that. So that's a cool one. And then this is a side pocket. Well, you could use it like that, but I thought it'd be cool to be like a side pocket. I could use my little pointy finger stamp. So you got two pockets there. And then what I have here, and this gel print envelope, I put up a do not crush in a big hand. Thought that'd be fun. This little mini book that was on a video. Extra book page, some other tags, some scrap there. So on these, I just put some of coffee dye paper on the back and people can write on them. I haven't decided exactly what I'm gonna do with them, but they're, you know, they can be written on. That's more. This one's another one I made. Brads, that's what they're called. They're called Brads. So I got these mini Brads. So this is from one strip of paper. I have to reacquaint myself with how I made it again. I think I forgot who made it on YouTube, but I'll have to get the name. So there's a little pocket right here. I need something. Here we go. Got a little pocket here. And then we have, flip it open, you got two pockets there, and that's it. You got your closures. So that one's fun. I just covered it in different stamps. And that's that. That one. And then these are similar to the other ones I just showed you from scrapbook paper. So we have the two pocket here. This one's a three pocket. One, two, and then three. And this is another one of those little ones. It's got a little tuck spot in here. This one is cool. So this one has the pocket here in the front. And then on the back side, got another pocket. So you could do, get one of these small ones here. I know it's not the right size for this, but so that's how that would work. Got that there. Look, that fits perfectly. The little face is showing. Yeah, get a little something in there. These are just journal cards that I haven't added. Okay, see, that's the backing. Just some paper to write on. Do those. Not sure what I'm gonna do with that. Here's some other pockets I made. Scrapbook paper. Actually, this is gel print. And then this is scrapbook paper. Just your, you know, everyday pockets for your journal. You glue on, put on a page. Like that. That'll be great. Same with this one. This one's just a little bit smaller. Got some butterflies. This is the same paper. You can see. And do I have anything else? Let me look in my box of stuff here. I just want anything else that I haven't shown you yet. But I think all the other things I have here in my stash, you've seen in videos already. So yeah, some of the stuff I have in here, these are stuff that I've made in other videos. Okay, so that's that. So we made, so we've got our three journal covers here using little golden books. And I think they're awesome. And so hopefully coming up soon, I will be ready to start putting together signatures and then hopefully sewing them in. So thanks for joining me today. I hope you enjoyed it. Don't forget to hit like and subscribe, and I'll see you next time. Bye.